You know, it's good to be wanted. That's what I know. When there's somebody out there and they're looking for you specifically, it feels good. You want to be wanted, don't you? You want someone to make that commitment. Come on, seriously. It's time to lock it in. If you really want it, you need to step up to the plate and let somebody know you want it. Broadcom has stepped up to that exact plate that we're talking about. It's about time someone's ready to make a commitment. I'm Cody from Wall Street Breakdown. It's Monday. We're back with more financial news, and I would imagine you love it, right? We love intrigue, and we're back with a little more of it only mere days after announcing they were exploring purchasing or making an unsolicited bid for Qualcomm. Broadcom has come out and officially made that bid, just like we were expecting, $70 a share. That's a valuation of $130 billion in market cap, and that puts Qualcomm at a price of about 28% premium from what they're trading today. Now, Qualcomm has a lot of issues. They've got a lot of contracts with a lot of companies, including Apple, that they're currently in litigation with, and they're not getting paid the royalties for their semiconductors that they've been expecting. So they're not doing as well as they would hope. And on top of that, they probably haven't made any friends with this. Unfortunately, in an industry so tight together, semiconductors and the smartphone makers, you're not really making a lot of friends every time you end up in court with somebody. We've seen this before. So the big problem is, with Qualcomm, they're not bringing in the money they want. They've got an offer that gives them a 28% premium from Broadcom, and their name isn't associated necessarily with really good work right now. Let's just say the partnerships between them and other people have ended up in court. Nobody wants to see that, right? Because then people don't feel comfortable doing business with you. So when your board of directors and your shareholders see a 28% premium offer, why would you not take it? Let me think about that. There's no reason why you wouldn't take it, silly. 28% for a company that really could probably use Broadcom a lot more than Broadcom could use Qualcomm, but Broadcom sees Qualcomm as a real influx in a whole lot of really good proprietary stuff. I mean, let's face facts. Qualcomm's going to bring a whole lot to the table, but Broadcom has a lot of negotiating power with a lot of these companies. Then they haven't burned the bridges. You all of a sudden remove the name Qualcomm from everything, and all those goodies that you bring over proprietary-wise into the Broadcom fold become a lot more usable again because you don't have that same litigation history with these other companies. So Qualcomm could make out like bandits at a 28% premium, and Broadcom could bring in a lot of good assets for what is a very strong valuation. Let's not get that wrong. But I think they see a lot more long-term value in it than what they're paying in a 28% premium. Broadcom's a smart company. They know what they're doing. I definitely would trust this move. I'm Cody from Wall Street Breakdown. If you haven't already, click the subscribe button. Click the notification bell. Thumbs up for this video. Thumbs up for all the videos. And leave us a comment. We love hearing from you, and we want to know what you think. I'm sure Broadcom or Qualcomm touch on somebody's portfolio out there. We want to know exactly how this potential acquisition affects you. And that means you got to leave a comment, because that's the way this little interaction between us is going to work. I can't hear you if you're just talking in your living room.